May Allah's peace and blessings be upon you, my beloved Holy Prophet and the Ahlul Bayt. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon you. It was in your homes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us with guidance and revelation. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon you. Angels descend upon you day in, day out, seeking permission before entering upon. Take our hearts to the lonely graves of al-Baqi, to the beautiful soil above the graves of the Ahlul Bayt. Let's all pray tonight in our lifespan. Can we see the day that we could throw ourselves on the graves of our beloved imams, touch them, perform ziyarah, cry and beat our chest around the graves of the Imam Baqir sallallahu alayhi Ya Aba Ja'far, Ya Muhammad ibn Ali, Ayyuha al-Baqir. Brothers and sisters, it is said according to accounts, Imam al-Baqir, after all the efforts to bring that awareness to people, after all the efforts to try to save the ummah, bring them a government that would bring prosperity to them, when the government realized they could not deal with him, they took him to Sham. They imprisoned your beloved Imam in Sham. When they saw his imprisonment does not help, when they saw that in prison he's guiding people, he's bringing awareness to his companions in prison, to the people there in prison, they had to send them back to Madinah. Eventually they poisoned your Imam. We don't have much accounts, brothers and sisters, of the last moments of Imam al-Baqir. But knowing his circumstances, maybe at those moments when Imam al-Baqir was being poisoned, when he realized his fate, when he realized that maybe he remembered the ghurba of Amir al-Mu'mineen in that city, maybe he remembered his mother, the lady Fatimah al-Zahra, in her pains in Medina. Maybe he said to himself, although I've been poisoned here, but la yawmka yawmka ya Aba Abdillah. Maybe he says, I was there as a child, but nothing compares to what happened to Imam al-Hussain in Karbala. Why is that? What happened? What happened? There are so many things that happened, brothers and sisters. that one can really not speak of it oneself. One of the very painful sights in Karbala is when the Imam Salamullahi Alayhi Ruhi Lahu Al-Fida had already fought all alone. He had ended up on the ground. The family members of the Imam had realized that. How did they realize? Some say the horse of the Imam had gone to the tents. The women and children thought that their father is back, their uncle is back, their brother is back, coming out to see the horse without its rider, filled with blood. The women and children came to run to find Abu Abdullah. Brothers and sisters, usually we have heard the lady Zainab in the story. You hear that she is there witnessing what happens. But brothers and sisters, there's another story there as well. The story is another soldier of Imam al-Hasan. It says Abdullah ibn Hassan, the orphan of Imam al-Mujtaba, seeing his uncle on the ground, helpless, seeing the enemy above his head with a sword ready to strike, could not stand this scene. Abdullah runs to his uncle, faces the enemy. Look at the bravery of the son of Imam al-Hasan. I will not allow you to strike my uncle. But Abdullah, you don't have any weapons, you don't have any shield, but I have my hands. He extended his hands to protect his uncle. The enemy strike, reminiscent of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas. Abdullah ibn Hassan also loses his hands. Imagine what happens in the hearts of Imam al-Husayn. Abdullah, why didn't you stay with your aunt Zainab? Abdullah, it pains me that I cannot help you. Ala la'natullahi ala al-qawm al-zalimin. Wasaya'alamu al-lazina zalamu ayyamqalabin yanqalibun. Allahumma anna nas'aluka wa nad'uuka اسمك العظيم الأعظم الزهراء وأبيها وبعلها وبنيها السر المستودع فيها لك يا الله 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 يا رحمن يا رحيم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك وعلى محبة أوليائك والله hasten the return of our imam. Enable us to be his true and close companions. Enable us to serve him until death. Ya Allah, protect and prolong the life of all those helping the cause of Islam, all those protecting the shrines, all those protecting Islam and Muslimin. We ask you to protect and prolong, especially the Maraja, prolong their lives. Ya Allah, forgive us all of our sins. Forgive our parents, our grandparents, our relatives, all believers, those who are alive, those who have passed away. Ya Allah, we all have hajat. We have needs. We have requests. There are ill amongst us. Some of us are suffering from significant and serious illnesses. We know relatives We have loved ones with illnesses. There are believers we may not even know of. We ask you by the right of Abdullah ibn Hassan, by the right of Imam al-Baqir, that you grant all believers their needs, their requests, their hajat, cure all the ill. O Allah, we ask you by the right of this warrior in Karbala, that you relieve the believers of the enemies that are facing them, especially our brothers and sisters in Iraq. Ya Allah, we ask you by the right of the Imam of our time to relieve all the people of the world.